want to be able to see the water up the shaft about 30 centimeters, like quite a long way, okay? So you want to be able to see that blade really buried, because that's very important to get good connection. What I want you to do, to demonstrate how light the oar is, put this side oar flat on the water, and with the other side oar, just have it so it's only just under just on the water, so it's just level with the top of the water, the top of the blade level with the top of the water. Top of the blade level with the top of the water. It's only just there. Now what I want you to do is we'll do it in two so that we don't have too much strain on the holding it. In the bow two, I want you to just pull with your arm just like this, just pull through like that. Alright, now I want you to go back and put it in again and put it deep so that the water comes up the shaft about that far. Now I want you to pull again. It's fairly heavy, isn't it? Much heavier the second time. And that feeling is actually connection. So what you want to do is you want to put the blade in and have it really connected so that when you do drive, there's no slip. So that's why we put the blade in deep. Can we have the stern pair try it, just to demonstrate? So have the blade just buried and just pull it towards you. Just do it again, but don't put it so deep. So it's just sitting just under the blade, it's just buried just like that. Just level with the top of the blade, level with the top of the water. So now try and pull it that. And I now put it back in the water and put it in quite deep so that the water comes, not quite that, yeah, about 30 centimetres up the shaft. Right, and now pull it again. Feel the difference? And so that's what connection's about. So when we put the blade in at the catch, we want to put it in deep, get connected, pick up the load, and then we accelerate. The sequence is really important. Put it in first, put it in deep, pick up the load, and move. You'll know though that as you put it into the water, if the boat's moving, you're going to move down the seat a little bit because you have to, because the blade's moving through the water. But the critical step, put it in deep, let it push you a little bit, and once it's connected, then you push. So you've got to feel for that connection. The best rowers can feel when it's connected. So you've got to really pay attention to how it feels in your handle so you know when it's in there. Other thing to do is come down the side for me, all of you, at the catch, and have the blade just. Okay, now put the blade so that it's underwater. Keep this side flat, perhaps, just make it easier. Right, I put that blade in so that it's the depth that we want to have it at the catch. So look at your blade, make sure that it's under the water and the water's about 30 centimetres up the shaft. So a bit deeper in the bow there. Right, now what I want you to do is hold the blade there and look where your arm is in relation to the side of the boat. Okay, so what angle is it in relation to the boat? And you'll see it's almost parallel with the boat. So now put your oar down so it's just sitting flat, so it's just touching the water. Make them square and just bury them to just the top of the blade. And now, note where your arm is now in relation to the boat. So watch me for a minute. So you can see your arm's about there. When it's deep, it's going to be about there. So now make it deep, and I want you to remember where that arm is. So you know when you put the blade in, your arm's got to come up that far. Does that make sense? Righto. So cool, so if the bow person, you can sit out again. And so what I want to do here is to demonstrate, so go to the finish for me, is, no, you don't stay there. So now come into the catch, where you're all square and out of the water. Now, what I want you to do here is, when I say I want you to put the blade in, and then I want you to push just a little bit, only a tiny bit. So I'll say on three, one, two, three. So the sequence though is up with the hands, then we push. Very important, it's up with the hands, then we push. So let's do it again. Put the blade in, then push. And so when we're out there rowing, I want you to separate those two movements in your mind. Now the catch is really quick. It takes about, a really good catch takes about a tenth of a second, maybe a 20th, so it's really quick. But in that time, we want to separate the up from the push. Okay, so it's up, push.